Hello friends, welcome to our channel Tours and Foods. Today we are going to share a detailed tour plan of West and South Sikkim. Here we will mention the main places to visit, where you can stay, how the cost will be. In a nutshell, you will get all the necessary information you need to visit these places. Best time to visit here is from October to May. Day 1. Here we start our journey from New Jalpaiguri railway station. But if you are visiting by air, then you can reach either Bagdogra or Pakyang airport first. From New Jalpaiguri, take a reserved or shared cab to reach Peiling of West Sikkim. It will take almost 6 hours to reach Peiling from NGP. The time of this journey increases or decreases depending upon the traffic jam or road condition. A reserved cab fare varies between ₹4,000 to ₹5,000 for this trip, depending upon the number of seats available in the car. A shared cab will charge around ₹700 per person. Here, I would like to mention that the town Peiling has three parts: Lower, Middle and Upper Peiling. Try to book your stay at Upper Peiling because it is the most beautiful among these three locations. Day 2. On day 2 of your tour, go for local sightseeing tour around Peiling. A local cab will charge around ₹2,000 to ₹3,000 for this local trip. First, visit the new helipad at Upper Peiling area. The place is situated at a comparatively high region and is famous for gorgeous views of the surrounding mountain ranges. Next, go to visit Shingshor Bridge. It is the second highest gorge bridge in Asia, located just 5 km away from Peiling. It is the highest bridge in Peiling. The surrounding green mountains and gushing river below this bridge looks absolutely stunning from the top. Here you may enjoy a walk around this bridge. From Shingshor Bridge, go to visit Changre Falls. It is located close to Shingshor Bridge. This scenic waterfalls is surrounded by the lush green mountains of West Sikkim. From distance, the waterfalls appear as a milky white line that is descending from top of the mountains. Next, go to visit Pemyangshi Monastery. It is the oldest and most famous monastery of Peiling. Enjoy the calm and quiet surroundings of this monastery. Entry fee here is ₹20 per person. From Pemyangshi Monastery, go to visit Rabdanse Ruins and Bird Sanctuary. The entry fee to this complex is ₹50 per person. The bird park here houses some rare species of mountain birds like white pheasant, golden pheasant, etc. A 30 to 40 minutes hike through the dense mountain forest is required to reach the Rabdanse Ruins. Needless to say, this walk is very refreshing. At the end of this walk, you will come to the old palace complex of the second capital of Sikkim, Rabdanse. It was the capital of Sikkim from 1670 to 1814. Though in ruins, you can see the gorgeous palace complex here. Archaeological Survey of India is currently maintaining this site. The last itinerary for this day is Peiling Skywalk. At present, it is the most famous tourist attraction of the region. The road to Peiling Skywalk has 6 sharp turns, and this is another zigzag road of Sikkim. The entry fee to the park complex is ₹100. On one side of the complex, there is a large statue of Chenrezi. At the base of this statue, there is a Buddhist temple. On the other side of the complex lies the glass skywalk. It is quite adventurous to walk on this glass panel, through which you can clearly see the road several feet below. Day 3. On day 3, early in the morning, start your way towards Rimbi Falls. It is another scenic waterfalls of the region. It is 20 km away from the Peling town. From Rimbi Falls, go to visit the most famous Kanchenjunga waterfalls. You need to purchase a ₹20 ticket to enter into the main falls area. Here you can also enjoy zipline trek. After Kanchenjunga waterfalls, move towards Yoksam. It is a small village of West Sikkim. From Yoksam, the way to Mount Kanchenjunga base camp starts. The road to Yoksam is very beautiful. On your way, you will see small picturesque villages and lots of roadside flowers. A 15 minutes walk is required to reach the Coronation Throne complex from the car parking. The main place to visit here is the Coronation Throne of First Chogyal. The Coronation Throne complex is now maintained by Archaeological Survey of India. The place has high historical importance to the Sikkimese. Beside the Coronation Throne complex stands a big building that houses a giant statue of the first Chogyal of Sikkim. From Yoksam, go to visit Khechipedi Lake. 10 minutes walk is required to reach the side of the lake from the car parking area. It is a holy lake 34 km away from Peli. The lake is surrounded by prayer flags. The lake houses numerous fishes in it. If you wish, you may feed the fish, and fishing is strictly prohibited here. The scenic beauty of this place needs a special mention. The cafe for the day will be same as day 2. If you are not visiting Yoksam, to visit Yoksam you have to pay ₹1000 more for cab fare. Day 4. On day 4, early in the morning, start your tour towards Ravangla. Ravangla is 52 km away from Peling and it will take around 2 hours to reach Ravangla from Peling. Cab fare is around ₹3200 for this trip. The cab fare may vary depending upon the number of seats and season time. At Ravangla, Buddha Park is the best place to visit. We suggest that you try to stay near this location, as the scenic beauty and surroundings of this place is the best in whole town. Here, a good mid-range hotel will cost around ₹1000 to ₹1500 per day for a double bedroom. Upon reaching Ravangla, first check into your hotel and then go to visit Buddha Park. The entry fee to the park is ₹50 per person. The park is open from 9 a.m. to 5 p.m. The formal name of Buddha Park is Tathagata Sthal. At the center of this park, you will see a beautiful tall statue of Lord Buddha. At the base of this statue, there is a museum and meditation center which is open to all. The museum shows the life story of Lord Buddha. Surrounding the central statue, there is a well-manicured garden with ample sitting arrangements. In the middle of the garden, you will find a beautiful fountain. At the entrance, there are some small eateries and souvenir stalls. You can spend hours here without getting bored. From Buddha Park, go to visit Ralang Monastery. It is just 10 km away from Buddha Park. The architecture of this monastery is stunning. Like other Buddhist monasteries, this place is also famous for its calm and quiet environment. Day 5. On day 5, early in the morning, go for South Sikkim tour. For a day-long South Sikkim tour, a local cab will charge around Rs. 3000. First, go to visit Temi Tea Garden. This is the only tea estate in Sikkim. The tea garden uses only organic fertilizers for tea production. Located amidst the green Himalayan mountains, this is one of the most beautiful tea gardens of the world. Try to visit this place early in the morning because then only you can see the tea workers plucking tea leaves from the garden. From there, go to visit Siddheshwara Dham. Located in Namchi, this place has replicas of four dhams of India such as Badrinath, Jagannath, Dwarka and Rameshwaram. Other than these holy places, it also houses the replica of 12 Jyotirlinga temples. The entry fee to the main temple area is Rs. 50 per person. The place is most popular for the 108 feet tall statue of Lord Shiva, which is located at the center of the main temple area. From there, go to visit nearby Sai Mandir. It is a beautiful temple dedicated to Shirdi Sai Baba. The last destination for this tour is Samdrupse Hill. The entry fee to the area is Rs. 20 per person. A 5 to 7 minutes uphill walk is required to reach the top, where you will see the famous 118 feet tall statue of Guru Rinpoche. At the base of this statue, there is a Buddhist temple which is equally beautiful. After visiting this place, head back to railway station or airport for departure. Where to stay? At Pelling, we stayed at Hotel Hillview, which is located at the new helipad of Pelling. The room charges here are very reasonable and the location is really beautiful. At Ravangla, we stayed at Red Panda Residency, which is owned and maintained by a local family. The hotel is just opposite to the main entrance of the Buddha Park. For total package cost and hotel contact numbers, please check the description box below. If you love this tour plan, then please like and share the video. Also, do let us know your opinion in the comment section below. Your opinion means a lot to us. Thanks for watching it.